It is with great pleasure that I welcome today in Cyprus the Minister of Defense of the Slovak Republic, Jaroslav Nat, and the members of his delegations. Slovakia and Cyprus are both members of the European Union since 2004, and I'm very pleased to note our strong bilateral collaboration in the fields of defense and security. I had the opportunity to express to my Slovak counterpart our deep appreciation for Slovakia's invaluable contribution of the Slovak contingent to UNFICIP for 20 consecutive years. An important contribution to peace and stability that is nowadays more important than ever, given the increasing provocations by the Turkish occupation forces along the ceasefire line. As UNFICIP mandate is renewed, actually today, we pay tribute to the importance contribution of Slovakia. We also noted with satisfaction that our bilateral collaboration is at a high level. In this context, we agree on a memorandum of understanding aiming to establish general principles and procedures to carry out our future defense and military collaboration. The cooperation within the framework of the memorandum will be carried out in accordance with the principles of mutual benefit. It is a milestone that will enable to create opportunities and possibilities for collaboration between our armed forces. In the same vein, we discussed Turkish escalating provocations in relation to Varosha, as well as Cyprus exclusive economic zone and maritime zones. I presented how Turkey disregards the calls by the international community and continues with its plans to create new fait accompli on the grounds. The international community cannot remain idle. Moving on, I would also like to touch upon a number of issues from our European agenda, as well as a broad range of regional and European issues, primarily in the context of security and defense in a spirit of mutual understanding. Notably, on the various European defense initiatives, such as the Strategic Compass, the European Defense Fund, and the European Capabilities Development. I also had the opportunity to ask Minister Nat for Slovakia's expertise for addressing hybrid threats. Slovakia has developed an action plan for the fight against hybrid threats, and it was really interesting to listen to the country's experience and expertise on the issues which is of close interest to us for the resilience of our societies. Dear Jaroslav, your visit takes place during a very critical time in Cyprus, not just for Cyprus, but for Europe in general. Turkey's ongoing provocative behavior and illegal actions within the exclusive economic zone of the Republic of Cyprus, in parallel with the opening of the part of the fenced-off city of Varosha, test the credibility and ability of the European Union to effectively protect its vital interests as well as the sovereign rights of its member states. The statement of the UN Security Council resolution on the 23rd of July that condemned Turkish and Turkish Cypriot leaders to partially reopen the abandoned area of Varosha and call for an immediate reversal of the decision, respond swiftly and robustly to the disconcerting developments in Cyprus. But we note that the seriousness of the developments in Varosha need to be assessed and addressed in a more drastic and effective measures by the international community. The statement by the EU High Representative on behalf of all EU member states has also sent a very strong and clear message to Turkey for condemning recent Turkish actions on Varosha and calling for its revoke. The EU can make use of its various toolbox for convincing to Turkey a very clear message to stop its aggressive behavior against Cyprus and for respecting international law and order. Before turning the floor over to you, I wish to thank you once again warmly for taking the time to visit Cyprus in these particular challenging times, and I look forward to continuing our deliberations over lunchtime. thank you for your country's contribution and commitment for peace in Cyprus. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, dear Halalambos and your colleagues, really thank you for a very warm greeting that I have received from you and your colleagues from the first moment since arrival here in Cyprus. It gives me a real pleasure to announce that just a few hours from my arrival, we have the first result of my official visit to Cyprus, and that is obviously the memorandum that we have signed, memorandum of understanding between the Ministry of Defense of the Slovak Republic and Republic of Cyprus on cooperation in the field of defense. Indeed, I value this all the more as we mark this year the 20th anniversary since the Slovak Republic and its armed forces were first deployed to serve in Cyprus to bring and or to help to bring peace and stability to this region. And also the Slovak Republic has been contributing militarily for 20 years and diplomatically for almost three decades, which has obviously fundamentally shaped our bilateral ties. We have so far missed out on a contractual basis, the legal framework agreement for fostering our excellent cooperation in defense. And now we have it, and I'm so happy that that this can move our relationship forward for another step. I would like to take this opportunity to use this opportunity to thank you personally, but also to your colleagues for negotiations that really came very friendly, but also professional and flexible a few weeks ago, that started a few months ago when we started to negotiate the current memorandum that we have signed. This memorandum sets the main principles and procedures for delivery in many areas. Let me mention the joint exercises, let me mention joint exchange of students, let me mention cooperation in armaments possibly, and in many other areas that our experts would find important. And I would like to mention especially the PESCO projects of the European Union. But as we have mentioned, we have discussed also commented on many other areas, including, and I was very much surprised about your knowledge about the hybrid action plan that our government is to approve very soon, and where the Ministry of Defense of the Slovak Republic is responsible for its preparation. Because yes, both of our countries are a target, I would say, of hybrid operations against our security, I would say, targets or goals that we have in our respective regions. We have also discussed concrete modernization plans of the armed forces, and I can tell you that the Slovak defense industry is very active also in this region and successful, and I would like to make another step forward in these areas. And also we have discussed possible cooperation in the mining, demining programs, especially of the European, of the United Nations. So thank you again, thank you once more, and I'm really looking forward to our further cooperation and further steps that we will most probably will be able to reach in the next month to come. And I officially would like to welcome you, to invite you to Slovakia soon for further discussions. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and we'll be continuing after our lunch.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Thank you very much.